see the whole thing there. Zoom out. Zoom out. Okay. Let me say something first before just keep continuing. He's doing something which I find personally motivating to figure out. Because I don't think you can actually have sets of this, you know, at home and try to see whether you really, what's the physics involved when you throw a ball down. Okay, so Jeffrey, carry on. Okay, my name is Jeffrey, so good afternoon, everybody. Okay, my theory behind this is actually very simple. But I shall run this first and then you'll see what's going on. About contact force. Contact force is equal to your overall weight.
Yeah. Really? Is it all time? Contact force equal to overall weight?
Okay. So, contact force is the same as the FG, which is gravity. And then it includes the mass. When you see the length of this is actually equal. Yeah.
Sorry, I have to stop checking there because the physics is wrong, can you point out what's wrong?
It's not equal to...
Okay. Why is it not equal? Jeffrey, do you know why is it not equal?
No.
Do you realize you said something which is not
correct?
Must include
the mass.
Must include the mass. Okay, maybe I help you by looking at this and see. Never mind, you carry on with the presentation.
Oh,
you need to think a bit, Okay, Jeffrey says, Jeffrey, what do you say? You said the gravity force is equal to the
contact
force. Okay, let's see, contact force. Unfortunately, interactive physics has though it is a very powerful software, but sometimes there is still some limitation. So I can only show the total force. Okay. So according to what Jeffrey has said, he's basically, okay, then after that, they have some arrows, so we run and see. So I'm going to stop it at the appropriate time so that Jeffrey can carry on his idea. Okay, carry on. From here, right, Jeffrey, you were saying something about the contact force.
Yeah.
You were saying something about the contact force equal to the weight, right?
Yeah, the length of the arrow is the same.
Okay. Agree? I actually not say. How come you compare the same?
I did not see it was covered. So this is actually longer.
So it's actually not the same because how do we show it here is we can click on this. Actually, Jeffrey is doing something very interesting because he is he's trying to explain it the way he understands it. So it's good that he shows some misconception. Because if without this misconception, sometimes you don't understand what are the things that students don't see. Okay, so let me try to address this misconception. Okay, first thing before Jeffrey says talk about this thing, but let me just correct the physics first. He claims that the weight is equal to the contact force. That is not true. Agreed? Because this is on the slope. You look at the total force. The total force is 0.411. So if Jeffrey says that the weight equal to the contact force, then there should be no total force. Okay? So only that part of physics is wrong. So because it's wrong physics, I need to address it before the thing propagates. Okay? So Jeffrey, carry on with the rest.
Now I'm talking about Newton's first law, which is
body remains at rest or continues to move with a constant velocity in a straight line unless a net external force acts on it. As you can see, this domino is at rest now. But then, after the ball came to hit it, it moved. So this shows that the ball is like a net external force that has acted on the domino, which causes it to move. So that is Newton's first law. Right?
Very interesting way of looking at the world. I never thought of it that way. Maybe we talk about this because Gary hasn't presented us yet. Maybe I try to address this again in the next class. Okay. It's a very fresh, he's giving something very fresh. I never thought of it that way, but something is fishy. Like. Let me go and think about it. What's wrong with it?
Yeah, it's basically all about Newton's.
Okay. Never just carry on, just continue.
So it's basically more of Newton's first law, as the object will be stationary unless there's a net external force that acts on it. Yeah, so that's basically that. And when there's contact force is when something touches on another thing, then the contact force will be generated.
Okay, any other questions you have? Okay, if not, thank you. Last student, Gary.
Oh.